Hi, I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Today, I'm talking to you about what you need to be aware of if you're going to take benzodiazepines like Xanax, Klonopin, or Ativan. I've gotten several requests for this topic, with most of them centering around the issue of benzodiazepine withdrawal and what that looks like. Benzodiazepines, or benzos for short, is the class of drug that works at the GABA receptors in your brain to produce a relaxing or sedative effect. We use benzodiazepines to treat short-term anxiety and sleep. Some doctors will use them as a muscle relaxer, and Valium is pretty typical for this. They can also be used to stop a seizure. You may get Valium or Ativan prior to a procedure, such as a colonoscopy. The most common benzodiazepines are Ativan, Klonopin, Xanax, and Valium. Benzodiazepines are habit-forming, and it's easy to become addicted to them. And here's why. Benzos cause a tolerance effect, and this means that if you take them regularly, like daily or several times a week, over time, the effect can wear off, and you'll need to take more to get the same effect. So now, instead of, say, taking a half of a pill and having that work, now you notice that you need to take two pills to get the same effect. And this is a medication tolerance effect. It can happen to anyone, and it's not the same as an addiction. If this happens to you, it doesn't mean that you've been misusing the medication or have an addiction. Addiction involves developing a psychological dependence on it, where you need to take it. Now, you may say, how is that different from taking it for anxiety? After all, anxiety is psychological. Let me illustrate this. Phil has anxiety and sees his primary care doctor because he's not sleeping well. He has a lot going on at work and can't afford to go without sleep. He tells his doctor that he can't get his brain to shut down at night, and he's been having some panic attacks at work. His doctor gives him Xanax and tells him to take it as needed. Phil takes it, and he notices that he falls asleep as soon as his head hits the pillow. Then he takes it at work, and he doesn't feel anxiety for several hours. It doesn't make him sleepy, and he's able to get a lot more work done because now he can calmly focus. It's like magic. The directions on the bottle say to take up to 4 times a day as needed. Now, it says this because Xanax is a very short-acting benzodiazepine. It works quickly and it doesn't hang around very long. But a huge downside to it is that when it wears off, you can get rebound anxiety. And this is anxiety that can feel worse than the anxiety that you started with. So what happens? You take more to make that feeling go away. So this is eventually what happens to Phil. He takes it at work, but he and his wife aren't getting along very well. So when he gets home and she starts criticizing him, he takes another Xanax to deal with her. So he ends up taking the medicine 4 times a day, and a month later he tells his doctor that things are much better for him, but he needs a refill on the Xanax. His doctor says, okay, but he tells him that now the fluoxetine that he also prescribed should be doing its job, so he shouldn't need to take the Xanax as often. But Phil has a really tough month at work and took a little more Xanax to help him through that. When he asked for another refill, his doctor said that you need to see a psychiatrist. He comes to me and I give him my "this is why I hate Xanax" speech and switch him from Xanax to Klonopin with the intention to wean him off of the daily use. Klonopin, like all of the benzos, is habit-forming, especially when you get to where you're taking it every day. But Klonopin, and the generic name is clonazepam, is a longer-acting medication, and longer-acting medications have a smoother transition off when it wears off, and you get less rebound anxiety. Now, Phil has two things going on here. He's got the physical dependence because he needs to take the Xanax around the clock to control his anxiety, but he also has a psychological dependence, and this is how it looks for him. Since Klonopin is a longer-acting medication, it's prescribed a maximum of 2 to 3 times a day, less than the Xanax frequency of 4 times a day. Many people can get by with it just once a day. So I instruct him to take it 2x a day, 3 only if he feels he has to. Phil comes back early for his next appointment because he ran out of Klonopin. He admitted that it was his year end at work and he had a lot more anxiety, so he would take the Klonopin every 2 to 3 hours. Sometimes he'd only take half of the pill because he noticed that it did seem to work or to be a little stronger than the Xanax. Now, Klonopin lasts much longer than 2 hours. He shouldn't need to take it that frequently. But the problem was that Phil wasn't taking the pill because he needed it for his unmanageable anxiety. He was relying on the pill to deal with any kind of emotional distress. So when something bad would happen, his reaction would be to take a pill. And that's where he shifted from taking the benzo to treat anxiety to using it to take away any negative experience. So what happened to Phil? He said he just wanted to get through this busy period at work and then he would stop taking the Klonopin. And he promised, though, that he would not take it multiple times a day. After things slowed down at work, he and his wife went on a long weekend trip, but Phil forgot to pack his Klonopin. But he figured since he was planning to stop it anyway, then this would be the time on his vacation. On day 2 of the trip, he woke up in a panic and spent the entire day feeling as though his whole body was shaking. He tried to tough it out, thinking that maybe he was just reacting to something that he drank the night before. On the 3rd day, his wife found him on the floor unconscious and jerking. She called 911 and he was treated at the hospital for benzodiazepine withdrawal. Now, this is an extreme example just to illustrate what can happen. Most medication withdrawals, like what you can get from the antidepressants, are uncomfortable, but they're not dangerous. I did a video on brain shocks and antidepressants that you'll see in the corner, and I'll link to it in the description. Benzodiazepine withdrawal can be dangerous in that in extreme cases, it can cause a seizure. And this tends to be in people who have taken it longer than 3 months and take high doses, which, what's a high dose? It'd be a step or two higher than the starting dose. There's lots of withdrawal symptoms that you can get, but it usually looks like increased anxiety, tremors, poor sleep, irritability, or sweating. You can also get elevated blood pressure and heart rate. So is it ever okay to take benzodiazepines daily? The proper treatment for daily anxiety is an antidepressant. We also use medications like propranolol and buspirone. These medications are not habit-forming, and except for propranolol, they don't work immediately. The onboarding process can take a month to 6 weeks before you can feel some relief. So to help you feel better sooner than that, it's a common practice to also prescribe a benzodiazepine as needed for anxiety on a short-term basis. Short-term is generally considered 3 months or less. So this is what I'll tell someone in a similar situation. I'll say, this medication is to help your anxiety until the antidepressant kicks in. I would rather you not take it every day, but if you need to, it's okay for now. We'll keep our eye on it, and I'll help you wean off of it starting around 3 months. Now, things are a little different if you don't take it every day. There are people who get a bottle of 30 pills that lasts them 6 months or more because they only take it when they fly, and they fly 4 or 5 times a year, or they take it on average of once every couple of weeks. And that would be irregular use. I consider regular but infrequent use as weekly. I think twice a week is on the cusp of becoming frequent. And in my experience, once a person starts taking it 3 times a week, 3 becomes 4, and 4 becomes daily. Daily, long-term use is associated with cognitive changes, like not being as mentally sharp. It can also create balance problems in some people where you just aren't quite solid on your feet. And this can be a big problem with elderly people by increasing their risk of falls. If you've been taking the medication for more than 3 months and you're taking it daily, you definitely need to have your doctor taper you off slowly when you get to the point of discontinuing it. You don't want to just stop taking it suddenly. This is the kind of medication that you have to keep up with and not let it run out because you're leaving town and you notice that you only have 2 pills left. If you travel a lot or you just have a very busy life, these medications can create a tether to your pharmacy, which can feel very confining. The longer you've been taking it daily, the slower your taper should be. And there's not a set protocol for this. Your doctor would use his or her clinical judgment on a case-by-case basis, but how long it takes also depends on how high your dose is. I've had people where it's taken a couple of years to slowly wean off. We just keep chipping away at the pill size over months. It's like tricking your body into realizing that it's getting less and less medication. One of the ways I help patients avoid this problem is I tell them to think of the medication as a break-the-glass pill that you take to keep from going to the hospital because you feel like you're having a heart attack. It should not be a take-the-edge-off-of-a-crappy-day pill. When you start to think of it that way and take it that way, it very easily becomes something that goes from infrequent to daily. And once you enter daily use, you become tethered to the medicine and need to take it daily just to feel well. Now, I have to emphasize that everyone is different, and there are people who are able to take one benzodiazepine a day for years and never need to increase their dose. My thought about that person is that it may be that they no longer have the problem that they originally took it for, whether that be sleep or anxiety. But they think they still need it because if they stop taking it, they have terrible anxiety or don't sleep. But probably what they're experiencing is withdrawal and not a return of their original problem. If you want to see more on medication withdrawal from antidepressants, watch this video that I have on antidepressant withdrawal and brain shocks, and subscribe for more information on mental health education. See you next time.